Straight away is quite a difficult question. Difficult question because Paco getting in my life, you know, 5 years ago, and influenced in the way that I discover more things about myself. But because I've always done sport, you know, it's just a part of my life. And for the others, how I influence the others, I don't really know. You know, the fact is, I have a way of training, I have a way of moving, and maybe people, you know, are influenced because they can feel something from me, you know, who inspire them. But otherwise, you know, I'm just a normal guy. I'm just a normal human guy. So, you know, I feel pleased, you know, to hear that some people are inspired by me, but I don't know how much I influence them. And it's quite funny because few weeks ago I was talking with Stefan and he asked me nearly the same question. What drives you, you know, what makes you that you? And I just answered to Steph that every time I was doing sports or in my life, my goal is not to about victory. It's not about, you know, be able to do a jump and just afterwards, just that's it. My goal is always progression. And because it's progression, you know, I think that whatever the activity I'm doing, you know, I try to make my best into this activity. And every time, you know, I try to just progress. But progression doesn't mean that I will necessarily do big things. It means that psychologically, mentally, you know, I will discover something new about me who will make me progress as a human being. So, yeah, I think that parkour, he make me realize, you know, I can progress, keep progressing all time, and not necessarily physically, but psychologically and mentally. I think that good and hard training is just every time you train, you know, you have to, first of all, to be honest with yourself. You have to set up goals and try to at least reach them. And if you can, you know, go even further than this goal. This, I think, is a good and hard training. You know, the thing is, you have to understand that the pain in the training is not necessarily something bad. But when you reach the point that you start to have pain, you have to find this force to go over this. But before that, you know, when you start the training, you say, okay, for example, today I'm going to set up this goal. And you're going to stay on your training until you reach this goal, at least. And most of the time you will see that the people who feel quite strong or feel stronger, they'll be able to go over this point, over this goal. So, and another thing, it's about regularity. Because for me, you know, hard training and good training is not something that you do just once. It's something that you'll be able to repeat. I think that in the long-term process, you know, to be able to have a methodology of training, to be able to wake up every day, you know, put your trainers and go to train, with this mentality, you know, I think is the hardest bit. Because it's very easy to give up. It's very easy just to say, okay, today I train very hard and tomorrow, you know, just I stay on my bed. And I think this is the hardest bit. The hardest. And good training is to be regular in the training and to reach the goal that you set up at the beginning. I think it's the same for any sport or any activities. You know, when you start, you will learn a lot. You will learn a lot because it's something new. So definitely you will discover every single day some new things. You will discover, you know, you'll be able to, after a few months, you know, from, if you compare with the beginning, you will understand that, yeah, I learned a lot and I improved a lot. And it's normal that with the time, you know, that you will reach a plateau, not necessarily, but the improvement will be just less. And it depends what kind of improvement, because if you work physically, the improvement, yes, will be slow. But if you think about the other aspect, you know, I was talking about the mental aspect, I was talking about the psychological aspect, I was talking about, you know, yourself, about understand yourself, understand your limit, understand, you know, how it works. This improvement, you don't have any rules to make an improvement, you know. So why are you going to set up a plateau? Yes, maybe in 5 years' time, you know, I'll be nearly 40. So physically, I won't be maybe capable to do all the stuff I'm doing now. But it doesn't mean that psychologically or mentally, I'll be strong enough to do some stuff maybe on the height without stress at all. And this is a certain form of improvement. So I really think that you can always improve. As I said at the beginning, you know, I was talking about progression. Progression is not something that you can stop. You maybe you won't be maybe as strong as before, but it doesn't mean that you can't progress. Oh, so yes, I'm a runner, and yes, I'm doing this kind of stuff. We can call as well interval training. And the interval training in the normal running is very, very interesting to make your heart working in different speed. So because of that, you're going to develop some ability to feel more comfortable when you change the rhythm. And it could be interesting in the parkour context, but this will be just to improve your stamina and to make that you will put your heart working in different rhythm, different situation. So after a certain period of time, it will make you more comfortable because you'll be able to cover maybe a longer distance with more obstacles without feeling the tiredness, because you'll be able to control easier, you know, your heartbeat. And because you control easier your heartbeat, you know, you can control easier the energy that you release every time you go over an obstacle. So you can save more energy. Okay, I don't know if it's just for the day, but my favorite animal is the black panther. Why? And it's because I love this animal because it's you have two contradictions. This animal is the representation of be strong, be powerful, can be brutal, but physically brutal. And in the same time, this animal is very elegant, very soft, very graceful. And somehow, I think that I'm a bit like that. Everybody said to me that I'm quite strong, but in some times I try to be light, you know, when I move. So I think that for a day, yeah, if I have to choose, it would be maybe the Black Panther.